Today we see numerical, which is based on the basic concept. I will read the numerical. SP5T is equal to 50 W per meter cube of 100 mm ID and 110 mm OD. Is to be covered with two layer of insulation, each having thickness of 50 mm. The thermal conductivity of first insulation material is 0.06 W per meter Kelvin, and that of the second is 0.12 W per meter Kelvin. Estimate heat loss per meter pipe when temperature of inside tube surface is 523 Kelvin, and that of outer surface is 323 Kelvin. If order of insulation is reversed, calculate change in heat loss with all other conditions kept unchanged. Comments on the results. In this problem, the first ID is given, internal diameter, given that ID is given, the value of ID is 100 mm. Then next is radius is R, that is 100 divided by 2, 50 mm. Then that is 0.05 meter. Then it must be converted into meter. 1 meter that is equal to 1000 mm. Okay. Then here OD is 0. OD that is equal to 100 mm. Then R2 that is equal to, that is half of the 155 mm. Then convert it into meter, 0.055 meter. Then radius R3, we can get 55 plus 50, that is equal to 105 mm. Then convert it into meter. Then how to convert 0.105 meter. This is a simple way to conversion. Then in this problem, whatever that we have provided, even is thermal conductivity 50 W per meter Kelvin. Next, KT is given 0.06 W per meter Kelvin. Then KC is given 0.8 W per meter Kelvin. Next, T1 is given 1.23 Kelvin. T4 is given 323 Kelvin. Okay, that information you have provided in the problem. First is the internal diameter, 100 mm meter. Then radius is half of that diameter. R1 is 100 divided by 2, that is equal to 50 mm. Then converted to meter, 1 meter that is 1,000 mm. Then indicator 0.0080 meter. OD, outer diameter is 100 mm. Then R2, radius is half of that. 50 mm, then converted to meter. We have the derivation of R1 plus R2. Then then convert into meter. Thermal conductivity of each layer, then the formula is very simple. T1 minus T4 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is simple formula. Then we substitute the value. And we get the number 2 divided by R1. R1 means that is a simple formula. Log of 1, it is 0.075, that is R2 divided by 0.05, that is 1.6 divided by 2.6 into 15 into 1. Okay, so this is what we take the length of another R2, 0.05. Zero point zero five, and 0.10 is 1. This is the problem. Then we calculate after calculating the value. The value of Q1 is very simple. 89.56. That is the value. That is the value. Then in this that is the value of Q1. Then once we calculate Q1, then calculate Q1 is heat transfer rate, then calculate Q2. The formula is the same. We are at 0.5. That is complete. Then plus in bracket, we substitute the value. Zero point zero five divided by zero point zero five five, that is complete. 2 point 0.2 into 1, that is complete. Plus 0.153 divided by 0.103 divided by 2.5 into 0.06 into 1, that is complete. Then calculate Q2, the value of Q2. That is equal to 105.4. If you compare both the two values, Q1 and Q2, in first case Q1 is less than the second case Q2. Hence, for reducing heat transfer from pipe, first case is recommended. Means the value of Q1 is the less than Q2, and hence for reducing the heat transfer compound. In this whole problem, we have to find out the heat transfer rate. Then, whatever information we have given in the problem, the first information is the ID of the polynomial, then we calculate the radius, then only outer diameter of the pipe is given, then calculate R2, then we can easily calculate R3, then the value of R1 plus R2. Then here one more thing is given in the problem. Homogeneity of each layer of the pipe is given because the pipe is made up in some layer of the pipe. Yes, this is the limit. Before the first is the laid down as compared to the chicken feet.